Annika Batra to begin this women's singles round of 32 bouts. Now, Batra uses the long pimples on the backhand side and she will serve with the inverted twiddle sometimes. There. Serve with the pips. Depends what she wants to start the rally with. But it's a very disturbing style to come up against because of how it disturbs the rhythm. Batra's forehand has the inverted rubber, so she'll hit that in a more orthodox way that Hayata will be a bit more accustomed to. Some fortune there for Annika Batra. Levels it up here. Two serves to come. Drives through the backspin there, Hina Hayata. Such a sprightly mover, twinkle-toed player. Now you can see the reverse effect of that loop. Batra puts the bat on it and it turns into backspin. That's why that forehand nets from Hina Hayata. The first one, if you don't give it much spin, will be no spin. And then you can kind of drive that one more. She needs a good start here, Annika Batra. Hayata is a momentum player. She gains confidence when she's in the lead, doesn't often lose when she's in front. Batra is playing with the intensity required so far. And it's not a nice style to come up against at all, never mind in your first round. We saw how Wang Manyu struggled with the style of Srija Akula. First round of the Singapore Smash. Akula is the national champion. And I think it's a good time to bring up how India did against China at the Worlds. Nearly beat them in the group stage. Oh.
4-6.
What a point from Batra. Whizzes it past Hayata there. Yeah, if you don't know about that Indian result against China, you must have had your head in the sand. Akula beating Wang Yadi 3-0 and Mukherjee beating Sunying Shah 3-1. Shows it takes something different to beat the very, very best.
6-6.
Gasp from the crowd as Hayata gets an unreturnable edge.
Six all. 7-6.
Back in front. Sweeps it under the carpet, Batra. Hayata needs to do something quickly. From Batra. What?
7-4.
How is that possible? You shouldn't have to be worried about that coming back. You shouldn't have to be worried about losing the point the way Batra just played it. That is nuts. It finishes in another edge. She can't even help but smile there, Hayata. listen to the screech of Hayata. That was a big one, wasn't it? Batra tried to twiddle to block with the backhand. Coach Daisuke Ishida, delighted that she's back in front. It's not for long. Such a captivating game. Enthralling play. Rhythmic rallies. Hina Hayata with a two serve sequence at 9-all in this first game. She miscontacts the backhand, but it's a receive of good intent from the Indian. Covers the forehand side with the backhand pips. And has a game point here. Could she take it? Oh, what a serve that is. That's table tennis right there. An ability to understand a pattern and feel your opponent, feel what they're not expecting. Genius from Hayata. But Batra has another. The forehand laying the hammer down. She'll be on receive in this alternating juice situation. Takes it. Probably was a couple of IOUs.
One block.
Just needs to centre herself here, the Japanese player. Recalibrate. Found her happy place.
Block two.
Batra goes for the blow. Tries to hit it too flat, doesn't quite keep her posture. Wide serve.
Try it!
Brilliant.
One, drop two.
A master of this style. Pushes long, but like a top spinny serve there from Hina Hayata, the way she whips it in. So springy. Just feel the kinetic energy of Hayata. And she expels it into every shot. This backhand was so accelerated. Sharp. Tomahawk inbound.
2-5.
Called to guarantee. A 2-point cushion hit. Angle was immense.
5-3.
Didn't look possible from where she played it. Ayata is doing a very good job here of turning the tide.
Four, six.
Just forehand has been well up to scratch. Because of her style, her equipment choice, she really has to stay close. But the fact she's tall as well doesn't really work in most cases. So she had to really work hard at her physicality and recovery. She can protect the middle well with the backhand there. Was in the kind of zone where she knew she had to play her forehands. Clever play.
7-5.
It's frustrating to play against this.
7-5.
You have to adapt. You have to play a different game to what you may be used to the way you want to. But you want to win. So do as you must.
Charlie!
Oh my God.
7-6.
Blurring the lines. These two players, fanning backhand from Batra, but the speed of which Hayata scurried across made me think Batra is going to be intimidated by that, but kept on it there, the Indian. One away from levelling. She's keeping the ball tied to the table marvellously. And she's had so much success with her forehand. This could be a turning point. Hayata knows that. Serves back with Batra.
7-8.
Good push. But still, tense, tight moment. Wide serve and an edge.
Well,
Batra won the game on one. Can't moan too much, but still so frustrating. The Indian there, understandably. The serve, though, did allow Hayata in.
Joy!
9-8.
Bubbling up nicely, this. Hayata has 2 game points. Full commitment from Monica Batra. And Hayata laughing as though to say, no, 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 no. You're not going to have that one.
A 10.
Oh. Two bites of the apple here for the Japanese. Oh, oh, why was that? One saved. For me, the longer this match goes on, the harder it may become for Batra to keep playing forehands over and over again. Hayato is now keeping on pinning the forehand of Batra, and with the long levers of the Indian, it's hard to get back time and time again with the bat high ready to play another. Batra's controlled so well with the long pips. Hayato isn't confident continuing with that.
2-1.
Tries to win a point outright with the serve. Doesn't land. Down the line.
1-3.
Has a cushion here early on, Hina Hayata. Backspin and then just slaps it away. Kaboom. It was all over in the blink of an eye.
3-4.
Guided flick. Back and forth.
3-4.
That was a good push. Happy with that one. Did not expect that angle coming back to where it came from. Took a lot of joy from that, the Japanese.
Left, 4-3.
If Batra could win this, we'd have a surprise quarter finalist because Dina Meshref faces the winner of this. Hayata is taking the reins now. When it rains, it pours.
Ten. 6-4.
Extra rotation to a good location. It's the woman from the Indian nation that is struggling here now. Ooh, that might have had a bit more snake bite. Batra may have struggled to charm it, but it wasn't that spinny and Batra just slaps it away there. The speed of this. How many shots were just played in the space of 3 seconds? Mind-boggling. Reminds me of some of the rallies we saw between Satyen and Batra and Hinahayata and Haramoto.
8-6.
The show must go on. Great block, and then into the middle. She's going to come in for another drop shot there, Batra.
Nice shot.
Landed. Right,
nine,
that was deadly. Venomous. I see her just patting her heart there. There is tension in the Infinity Arena. There's a hubbub of anticipation. The fans want to see what's going to happen, but they're enjoying every moment here.
6.
Hayata, who is one of the smiliest players on tour, has 4 game points.
11,
slow and spinny to the forehand, that's been the trick.
Hayata.
It's the way she's just sponged it up. And it takes a player of Hayata's speed to be able to play this sort of diversity, this amount of different shots in such a small space of time. She is just blistering Hayata. In every sense of the word. So swift.
2-1.
And Batra has been equal to her. Which is, again, so impressive. She knows how tall she is. Her and Paul Canova, two of the tallest at this level. Not quite placed and jumped into it. Bunny hop backhand, but Batra using the long pips more aggressively there. But they're kind of similar technique to what you'd play a short pimpled backhand punch, but so effective again at changing the rhythm. Squatting at the touch.
4-2.
Every shot is just designed to corrupt, to stall. This one here, fanning backhand technique, but with the long pips, and again.
4-2.
Some people think of long pips as a bit of a cheat code, but it has its limitations, and you've got to really be able to read it well. And Batra is one of the best. Her and Srija Akula. Probably the best two with long pips. Used in this way with inverted rubber on the forehand. It's an Indian speciality.
3-5.
Most of the top players in the world use inverted on both. But there's even a couple of pimple players in the top tier of the Japan women's team with Ojo, of course, the best two probably, Ito and Kihara.
4-5.
But those two are short pit players. Some of you may remember Aifu Kihara. Very famous player for Japan in the previous generation.
5-4.
It's a streak from Hayata. Neither player, Hayata, got a few points in a row there. She bluffs the serve. Serves with the long pips. Hayata was just having to react to every awkward shot. Batra was manifesting that. Oh, the push was nice, but the forehand couldn't match it. Hayata levels again. Second tiebreak here of the fourth. Very animated reactions. Production team do an amazing job of helping us see absolutely everything here in the Infinity Arena.
7-6.
Hayata's done a fantastic job here to turn the tide. Third ball kill drove through the float receive. Well, Coach Ishida wasn't, to my knowledge, a top player, but he can train with many different styles. And that can help Hayata in preparation for matches like this. There he is. Strawberry.
7-8.
And then tried to bluff the forehand, play a dummy forehand, we call it. Where you just kind of tease it up.
8.
Batra has leveled now. Seesawing game, must win for Manaka. Doesn't quite connect with the forehand as she wished there, Hayata. That was a mammoth point. Again, serves as well, one of the best three, arguably top three servers in the game. This would be immense for the Indian.
8-9.
Won both points off serve. Now has two of her own. 4 points in a row for Manaka Batra.
10-8.
A chance to send this to a climax game. Wider serve. Half long. In and out footwork being tested. Manaka Batra is delighted.
One love.
Manaka Batra takes the first point of this decider. Second two. Hayata under the cosh. huge point there. Can she level? Cushion. Something to work with here.
Come on, hey, Joe.
7 of the last 8 points to the Indian.
Three,
comes in there.
Two.
And it has to be with intent. Has to be strong, because otherwise she won't be able to get back out quick enough. And Batra blocks. Came across that on the pivot. So beautifully there, Hina Hayata. Look how fast she turns.
Drill.
How quickly she knows she won't be able to play a backhand from that position. Instinctive. All the hundreds, maybe even thousands of hours of irregular training.
Three, four.
Coach now, Aman Balgu, is going nuts for her. Appointed to her after a disappointing 2022 Commonwealth Games. Really helping her focus on her mental game. And her best results have come, funnily enough, after she won the Commonwealth in 2018. It's been an upward curve for Manika Batra. Hayata is her best ever win. If she could do it again. Oh, extra rotation. Managing to slow it down even when you're against a hard ball is so impressive. Couldn't get in the position quick enough for that one. Batra again, just stretched a little bit further. Makes all the difference now for the Japanese as she's one ahead at the change of ends. Dismissive.
Seven,
that was a peach from Hayata. Again, it starts with the backhand into wide forehand, and then she goes to the complete opposite side. A bit less hope in the eyes now of Manika Batra. She stares down Hina Hayata, down by two.
Six, five.
Almost better. Meshev could beat Hina Hayata. We've seen her even take Wang Manu to five, but a guaranteed surprise quarter finalist if Batra could do it. Hina Hayata, don't forget, coming off the back of a disappointing Singapore smash. Whoa!
Yeah!
I was amazed how she managed to adjust there, Batra. Look at Hayata's face. Some players could never even dream of being so relaxed and joyous in this moment, but that's the coping mechanism of Hayata.
Six.
Batra. Still here to party. Help of the net, but still had some work to do there.
Left. 8-6.
Nice.
6.
This is real cause for concern. Stretching ahead. That's gone wrong the last couple of points. Hayata, 2 away from surviving here in Incheon. Good work.
7.
Coming
9.
Off the long pips off that push, the ball just had that extra bounce. This one here. And all Hayata hits is air. 7-9.
7.
Three game and 3 match 10. Points. Different kind of reaction there from Hina Hayata. Been such a lesson in spin to spin orientated players who have both played their part in a spectacular match. Patra still in this.
8.
She takes it. 7th heaven for Hina Hayata. The world number 6, the 5th seed, sees off Manika Batra.